Thank you, sir.
Maatladukunte me time potu.
Sir, thank you, sir.
Neer maatladukunte me time.
For giving this opportunity.
Yes.
For me to discuss in the topic that is discussion and voting on the supplementary demands for grants. So this is the first batch for the year 2018 and 19, and also on the demands for excess grants for the year 2015-16, which are printed in the separate list, sir. So and also to pass the appropriation bills, sir. Sir, earlier in the last week of February, in the budget session, our party Telangana Rashtra Samiti, we have supported the budget of 2018-19 with some observations, sir. Sir, now I request the government to look into and to try to accommodate the following issues concerning our state and also the nation, sir. Sir, I'm happy to note that in this supplementary demand, sir, very good amount is being allocated for agriculture and irrigation, sir. Sir, you are well aware, sir, that the state of Telangana was allocated a amount by Niti Aayog for considerable amount was suggested by Niti Aayog.
You give valuable suggestions.
Sir?
Your time is limit 5 minutes.
No, sir, sir.
Instead of this,
no,
you can give valuable suggestions.
Yes, sir, I am going to give valuable suggestions, sir. That is with regard to irrigation, agriculture, education, health, and urban affairs, sir. Sir, the state of Telangana, sir, while bifurcation of the state of Andhra Pradesh, sir, in the AP state reorganization, the Andhra Pradesh state was supported with a budgetary allocation for construction of Polavaram project, sir. But no such allocation was given to the state of Telangana. Sir, now our state of Telangana is constructing very huge projects on River Godavari and Krishna as well, sir. So our Chief Minister, Mr. K. Chandrasekhar Rao Garu, had met the Prime Minister and also the Finance Minister many a times and requested for allocation of a budget and to declare a national status for any project which are under construction on River Godavari and River Krishna. Sir, in this supplementary demand, sir, I request the Honorable Finance Minister to see that at least some amount is allocated for these projects, sir. Sir, very recently, the Ministry of Agriculture, they assured us 2 Krishi Vigyan Kendras in the state of Telangana, one in the district of Mahbub Nagar and the other in Sirsila. Sir, when we met the Honorable Agriculture Minister, he says that lack of fund is the reason cited to us, sir. So I request the Finance Minister to see to allocate some budget in this grant for these 2 Kendras. And regarding the Navodaya Vidyalaya, sir, sir, the Navodaya Vidyalayas, they are intended to start in each district, sir. Sir, after 2015, the new districts which are formed across the nation, sir, no new Kendriya Vidyalayas are allocated money, sir, to start new Kendriya Vidyalaya, sir. So, Navodaya Vidyalaya, sorry. So, I request the Honorable Minister to see that some amount is allocated to HRD so that new Navodaya Vidyalayas can come up in the new district, sir, which are formed after 2015. Sir, with regard to the health, sir, sir, All India Institute of Medical Sciences, sir. This institute was allocated to the state of Telangana, sir. Sir, the undivided state of Andhra Pradesh, sir, in the undivided state of Andhra Pradesh, a hospital was proposed to construct nearby Hyderabad, sir, that is Nizam Institute of Medical Sciences, which is having around 200 acres, and we have already constructed a very big building, sir. So we offered that premises to the Ministry of Health, sir. Sir, if some amount is allocated in this supplementary budget and that hospital can come up very shortly, sir. Normally, you see, sir, the other AIIMS which are constructed across the country, they are taking a lot of time, 4 to 5 years, sir. Sir, here, if the Honorable Finance Minister, if he allocates some amount for this project, I think that this AIIMS can come up as early as possible in Hyderabad, and which can cater the needs of, not only the needs of Telangana, but also the nearby states of Karnataka, Maharashtra and Chhattisgarh, sir. Sir, with regard to urban ministry, sir, sir, smart cities is a flagship program of the Honorable Prime Minister. Sir, my district headquarters and where I am representing, Karimnagar, was also listed in the short, in the smart cities list, sir. Sir, but whenever proposals are coming to the urban ministry, the same reply, that is lack of funds, is the stock reply from the ministry. Okay. So okay. I request the Honorable Minister to see that some amount is allocated to the urban ministry. That, sir, this is the election year, whatever promises made by the Honorable Prime Minister, I'm requesting small projects, sir, flagship programs of this government only. That is opening of new Krishi Vidyalayas, new Navodaya Vidyalayas, and also the smart cities. So I request that the Honorable Minister may also concentrate to allocate some amount on tourism, sir. Sir,
thank you.
Sir, tourism, sir, Telangana, sir, normally in the undivided state of Andhra Pradesh, sir, Telangana region was neglected in tourism, sir. So we request the Honorable Minister allocate some amount for Prasad scheme. A scheme is also launched by this government in the name of Prasad. At least we request some Prasadam from the government for these projects, tourism projects. So thank you,
okay,
sir,
thank
for
you.
Giving this me.
The Honorable Members, those who want to lay their written speeches on the table of the House,